This time, vice versa naman tayo. Given a statement, we're going to paraphrase the given statement to conditional statement or if then statement. And then after that, let us identify the hypothesis and the conclusion. Okay, so what are the steps? We have two steps. Step one, identify first the hypothesis and the conclusion. After identifying the hypothesis and the conclusion, our next step is, write the word if followed by the hypothesis muna, comma, then followed by the conclusion, then period. Okay, next, example. Eating vegetables makes you grow healthy. First, identify what is the hypothesis. Okay, eating vegetables. Very good. And what is the conclusion? Makes you grow healthy. Now, if I will going to rewrite the given as if then statement, so the result will be if eating vegetables then makes you grow healthy. Now, the question is the thought complete?
No.
Kindly paraphrase the given statement para maging complete thought. Yes, Arjean?
If you eat vegetables, then you will grow healthy.
Very good. So, tatanggalin yung word na eating, papalitan ng you eat. So, the answer is, if you eat vegetables, then you will grow healthy. The second statement. A number ends in 7 is an odd number. What is the hypothesis muna? Very good. A number ends in? And the conclusion is? Okay. Now, if we're going to rewrite it as if-then statement, this is the result. If a number ends in 7, then an odd number. Complete thought?
No.
No. Okay. Paraphrase. Bautista.
If a number ends in 7, then it's
very good. So, dahil si 7 ay number, papalitan natin siya ng word na it. If a number ends in 7, then it is an odd number. How about the third example? Filipinos are hospitable. What is the hypothesis? Very good. Filipino. And what is the conclusion? Okay. If-then statement. If Filipinos, then hospitable? Complete thought?
No.
Okay. What do you think is the if-then statement? Kindly paraphrase. Origin again.
You are a Filipino.
Okay, very good. If you are a Filipino, then you are hospitable. Or pwede rin tayo gumamit ng noun. Ang ginamit ni Origin ay pronoun na you. So pwede natin be specific, pwede tayo magbigay ng pangalan. If Carlo is a Filipino, then he is hospitable. Okay, do you understand? Okay, this time, another example. All right angles are congruent. What is the hypothesis? Very good. All right angles. And what is the conclusion? Kung? Okay. If then statement. If all right angles then congruent? Is that a complete thought? Okay. Another hand. Yes, Bautista again. If all angles are right, then they are congruent. So, sino ba yung main topic? Yung all angles. Nagbigay siya ng halimbawa ng angles which is a right angle. Meaning, if all angles are right, ano ba measure ng right angle? Exactly 90. Meaning, kahit 10 right angle yan, pare-parehas pa rin yan ng measurement. So, dahil marami, gumamit tayo ng word na they are congruent. Do you understand? Yes. Last example. You get paid when you work. First, let us identify the hypothesis. Mutok. Very good. The hypothesis is when you work. Di ba may condition tayo? Ang magiging result nun ay yung conclusion. Ano yung condition natin? Kapag ikaw ay nag-trabaho, ano yung magiging effect nun? Babayaran kita. That is the hypothesis. When you work. Baliktad naman. And what is the conclusion?
You get paid.
Now, if then statement. If when you work, then you get paid. Okay. Is that all complete? Oh, now, para praise the given statement. Oh, anak, ikaw naman. Very good. If you work, then you get paid. So, any question? Do you understand?